In this video, we'll learn how transaction fees are different on Ethereum and Algorand. Transaction fees on Ethereum are called gas fees. Whenever you send a transaction on Ethereum, you have to pay gas fees, and it exists to keep the Ethereum network secure. It prevents bad actors from spamming the network or accidental infinite transaction loops that would crash the network. Ethereum gas fees consist of two components: base fee, which is the amount the transaction sender must pay to make the transaction eligible to be included in a block, and priority fee, which is a tip that the sender can add on to incentivize validators to include their transaction faster. So if the Ethereum network gets congested, validators will include transactions with the highest priority fee. This is one of the reasons why gas fees on Ethereum are dynamic and become more expensive when the network gets congested. Gas fees also increase as the complexity of the operation increases. So if you're sending a smart contract call transaction that executes computationally heavy code, gas fee will be higher than a simple payment transaction. Gas fees are also always paid regardless of the success of the transaction. So even if your transaction fails on Ethereum, you don't receive the gas fee you spent on the failed transaction back. So as a user, you have a risk of losing your gas fees whenever you send a transaction on Ethereum. Some people even choose to pay extra in gas fees to make sure that their transaction gets selected by the validators. Because if the validators don't select your transaction because of the low gas fees and your transaction gets canceled, then you're wasting your gas fees. Now let's talk about Algorand's fee structure. Algorand transaction fee is not dynamic like Ethereum's gas fees. Transaction fee on Algorand is fixed at 0.001 algo, regardless of the complexity of the transaction. So a simple payment transaction costs 0.001 algo, and a complex smart contract call also costs 0.001 algo. This amount only goes up when the Algorand network becomes congested. But you know, with the high TPS of 10,000 transactions per second, it's highly unlikely for the Algorand network to get congested. And to put this into perspective, Visa, a global payment card service provider, handles around 1,700 transactions per second on average. So that means Algorand is ready for global usage. Also, if for some reason your transaction doesn't get executed, the transaction fee is returned to you. So for example, if you call a smart contract method and the method only allows the creator of the smart contract to call the method, and you're not the creator, that transaction will fail and return your transaction fee to you. This is great as users won't have to worry about losing transaction fees and feel comfortable sending transactions on Algorand. So transaction fees are extremely cheap and stable on Algorand, allowing developers to build more transaction-heavy applications without worrying too much about transaction fees.